Hello, today we are going to learn about the four basic rules of logarithm. These are also known as the four basic laws of logarithm, and we are going to prove each one of these equations. The first equation, which is known as the first rule of logarithm, is log to the base a of mn is equal to log of m plus log of n. While the second rule, which is known as the quotient rule, is log of m by n to the base a is equal to log of m base a minus log of n base a. While the third rule is known as the power rule, and this rule is log of m power n to the base a is equal to n log of m to the base a. While the fourth rule is known as the change of base rule law. According to this rule, if we have two logarithmic terms, one is log of m to the base a and the second one is log of n to the base m, and this term, this m of the first log is equal to the base of the second log, then we can write this whole equation as log of n to the base a. So we will derive this equation one by one. But before deriving this equation, we need to learn about how to write a number in logarithmic form. Let's suppose we have a number 3 square. And we know that this 3 square is equal to 9. Now we have this simple equation. We can write this equation in the form of log as log of 9 to the base 3 is equal to 2. We just replace this 2 with 9 and this 9 with 2, while this 3 is converted into the base of the logarithm. So we can write any number in this form as a to the power n is equal to x. Now in this equation, a is equal to 3 and power n is equal to 2, where x, we know x is the number, this 3 square, which is equal to 9. So we can write this term in the logarithmic form as log of 9 to the base 3 is equal to 2, or log of x to the base a is equal to n. Using this simple equation and this simple method, we will derive these four basic equations of logarithm. Now let's prove these equations one by one. Okay, the first rule was the product rule law, and according to the product rule law, we have log mn to the base a is equal to log of m to the base a plus log of n base a. For proving this equation, look at to the right hand side of this equation. On the right hand side of this equation, we have two terms. This is the first term, log of m, and this is the second term, which is log of n. Now let's consider log of m to the base a is equal to x. And let's suppose that log of n to the base a is equal to y. Now converting this equation to simple form, we can write this as a power x is equal to m. And the second equation in simple form is a power y is equal to n. So we have two equations. The first one is m is equal to a power x, and the second equation is n is equal to a power y. Now we are going to multiply these two equations. By multiplying these two equations, we will get on the left hand side mn is equal to a power x multiplied by a power y. By multiplying these two terms, we will get a power x plus y is equal to mn. Now we are going to convert this back into the logarithmic form using this simple equation which we have explained in the beginning of the video. That is log of mn to the base a is equal to x plus y. We just convert this a into base and replace this x plus y with mn and this mn with x plus y. Now we have this new equation. Now we will simply substitute the values for x and y in this equation. By substituting the values for x and y that we have supposed in the beginning is x is equal to log of m to the base n, and we know that y is equal to log of n to the base a. By substituting these values, we will get log of mn is equal to log of m plus log of n, And this is known as the product rule of logarithm. Okay, the second rule of logarithm, which is also known as quotient rule, is log of m by n is equal to log of m minus log of n. Now we are going to derive this equation. Let's suppose again, look at to the right hand side of the equation, we have these two terms, log of m to the base a and log of n to the base a. Now let's suppose that log of m is equal to x and log of n is equal to y. And now we will convert these two equations back to normal form. The normal form will be a power x, this a will become this a, and we will simply replace the m with x and x with m. So we will have a power x is equal to m. And from the second equation, we will have a power y is equal to n. Now we will simply divide this first equation, m is equal to a power x, by the second equation, which is n is equal to a power y. By dividing this first equation by the second equation, we will have m by n is equal to a power x divided by a power y. Now further simplifying this equation, we can write this equation as m by n is equal to a power x multiplied by a power minus y. And now multiplying this a with this a, we will have a power x minus y. So we have this new equation, a power x minus y is equal to m divided by n. Now we will simply convert this back into the logarithmic form. In the logarithmic form, we will have log to the base a, xy will be replaced with m by n, and m by n will be replaced with x minus y. So we will have log of m by n to the base a is equal to x minus y. And we know the value of x is equal to log of m, and the value of y is equal to log of n. Substituting these values for x and y, we will have log of m by n is equal to log of m minus log of n. And this is known as the quotient rule of logarithm. Now let's prove the third rule of logarithm, which is known as power rule. According to the power rule, if we have log of m to the power n and base a, this term will be equal to this n will shift to this place, and we will have n log of m to the base a. So we are going to prove how this log of m power n is equal to n log of m. Now let's suppose we have a term log of m to the base a is equal to x. This is the first equation we have written in the beginning. Now from this equation we will prove the power rule. Now converting this equation to simple form, we can write it as a power x is equal to m. Now we will take n as a power on both the sides of this equation. We will have a power x whole power n is equal to m power n. This n and x will multiply with each other, and we will have a power nx is equal to m power n. Now we have this new equation, a power nx is equal to m power n. Now let's convert this equation back into logarithmic form. Converting this back into logarithmic form, we will have log of m power n to the base a is equal to nx. And in the beginning, we suppose that x is equal to log of m to the base a. Substitute the value of this x in this equation, we will have log of m power n to the base a is equal to n log of m to the base a. And this is known as the power rule. We use these equations, these rules and properties of logarithm to simplify complex equations in mathematics and physics. Now this fourth rule of logarithm is known as the change of base rule. According to the change of base rule, if we have logarithmic terms in this form, such as log of m to the base a and log of n to the base m, then we can write these two terms simply log of n to the base a. According to this rule, this capital M, the first term in the logarithm, will be equal to the base of the second logarithmic term. Now let's prove this equation. For proving this equation, Located to the left-hand side of this equation, we have these two terms, log of m to the base a and log of n to the base m. Now let's consider log of m is equal to x and log of n to the base m is equal to y. Converting this into simple form, we can write these two equations as a power x is equal to m and m power y is equal to n. Now we have these two equations, and using this first equation, we will proceed to the next step. According to the first equation, we have a power x is equal to m. Now taking y as a power on both the sides of this equation, we will have a power x whole power y is equal to m power y. And look at to this second equation. From this equation, we have m power y is equal to n. So we will replace this right hand side of this equation with n, and we will have a power xy is equal to n. Now we will convert this term back into logarithmic form. Converting this back into logarithmic form, we will have log of n to the base a is equal to xy. And now we will just replace this x with log of m to the base a and y with log of n to the base m. Putting these values, we will have log of n to the base a is equal to log of m to the base a and log of n to the base m. So this is known as change of Bayes' rule law of logarithm. That's it. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe EasyEDU for more.